Christopher Lee, again, who I'd met when we were doing Hard Day's Night. You know, he was probably making Revenge of Vampire 3 or something on the other set, and we'd seen each other, and he'd always seemed like a nice bloke, you know.
I either got a telephone call or a message through my agent saying, I've made a record called Band on the Run. I said, oh, yes. And he said, I want to have a very special cover to the sleeve. And he said, I've got some friends together. I want all of them to appear on the cover. And I said, fine. I didn't ask him what we were supposed to be doing or who we were. I just thought, you know, McCartney's just about the biggest name in music. If he wants me and some of his friends to appear on the cover of his latest album, then it can only be a compliment to me, and I'm delighted to be asked. So I said yes, and we got there, and they said, well, you see, this is what we're going to do. Because shot, of course, at night. It was in the dark. This is what we're going to do. We're going to pretend that, all right, on the run means you've escaped, presumably. So we want all these people to dress in these clothes, and we put on, all of us, the same sort of suits, which didn't, I must say, fit properly. Well, it didn't fit James Coburn either. It's a marvelous cover. I've got the record. They sent it to me. Didn't sign it, but they sent it to me. And so I still have it. And a lot of people have talked about it over the years, you know. Oddly enough, I was with James Coburn about 3 weeks ago here in London. We were having dinner. And he was talking about it, saying what fun it was. He was the one who was right up against the wall of the bank with his arms outstretched. And the rest of us looking suitably shifty and wanted men, as if we all had wanted posters above our heads.